Cold this stream, but I'm back. I'm still drinking, getting ready for this. What I really feel about Infinite Warfare and the what took so long? I hope you guys, Infinity War, don't think you get no kudos for this. What they implemented, if you haven't seen, even if you don't care, you should at least check this video out, because I want to know what took 3 months. Because I can't see, I really don't see what would have taken that long. I really don't. And I ain't trying to bash nobody. I'm just trying to say, it took 3 months for this?
Good to see you are still alive. Operatives only retain value in that state.
Yeah. So let's go to barracks, records, and here it is. This is the implementation of the barracks. This is where all your statistics are, from your mission team stats to your leaderboards to your medals, whether or not you prestige or not, and then, of course, your combat record. So I keep talking about leaderboards. Leaderboards are okay. It is just a narrative that we're going to go through today. And I probably should have labeled this combat record more explicitly. And what took so long for that? Because both these took a long time. Leaderboards took a long time. Combat record took a long time. Now, everybody knows I'm an average gamer. So if you're looking at my combat record and you're like, wow, this guy's not an amazing player. Okay, number one, I play solo. Number two, never claimed to be the greatest player alive. I'm just a gamer, just like some of you out there. I play non-competitive. I play pubs. So it is what it is. So let's get into this combat. Here's the combat record. Okay. I've got 5 days, 17 hours, and 51 minutes and 8 seconds in this game. And you're probably like, wow, you still playing that trash? Yeah, I'm playing it because I can't find anything else that I want to play. What else is out there to play? I like FPS shooters. I've played Titanfall. Titanfall's cool. But you know what? Hold on for a second. Let me adjust my audio. Titanfall's cool, but the thing about it is, it's just like Black Ops 3 or Infinite Warfare, the same movement, the same mechanics. So why play that when a whole bunch of people aren't playing it and it takes sometimes too long just to get a game? So I'm back on this. I could be playing Black Ops 3, but I'm tired of playing Black Ops 3 because I've played it. There's nothing that I really want to do in that game. So I wanted something new, something different. So without further ado, let's just start getting into some of the my best weapon. Of course, is the MV4. Everybody's best weapon is probably the MV4. It's the first weapon you get. It's how you start off. It's how you prestige. I am fourth prestige. And so with the MV4, I got 8,766 kills with a kill-death ratio of 1.52. 717 headshots, accuracy 0.24%. Who cares? I mean, no, I shouldn't say who cares, because everybody wanted leaderboards. Everybody wanted combat records. But for real, why did it take this long? You know, I've heard some of the rumors that explicitly that, you know, it was very dynamic, some of the things that they were going to be doing. They were going to be putting new, more in-depth information, things that we haven't seen before. I don't see anything here that I've never seen before. Is there anything here that you guys have never seen before? I can't say that it is. It's the same thing that we've always seen in every Call of Duty. So what took you so long? I mean, why would Activision even pay you any money for a game that's not complete? Hopefully they didn't pay you for everything. Hopefully they pulled back some money and said, look, you didn't turn out a finished product. Also, you turned out a product that everybody didn't want. And I don't think I'm gonna ever use you again. As a matter of fact, you need to be paying me to let you have your name under the umbrella of my company. So in this case, I'm like, Activision, what are you doing? Like really? You guys must be, I don't know. I don't know what do you guys think? Put something in the comment section below of this live stream and let me know truly what you guys think. I don't expect anybody really be in the broadcast because, hey, I don't stream that often. You know what I mean? I do not stream that often. And I just wanted to show my face real quick because, you know, I wanted you guys to see my expression as to what I'm seeing in this, and I don't see anything that's really that in depth. Hell, I could have drew some of these charts, you know what I mean? All they have here is bar charts, and these bar charts are made up with statistical math that you would put, even if you had it inside of an Excel spreadsheet. If any of you guys know anything about Excel spreadsheets, all you're doing right here is taking an average, taking those averages and just graphing those. If you take an algebra, you know how to do graphs. It's like right now what I'm looking at is I'm looking at my kills, and I'm looking at the KD graph, and it shows the average is the average right there shows a 1.79. So I had 3.5 kill death ratio in one game, 1.67 in another one, 1.06 in the other. So basically, among five games, they divide those scores by five games, and then you graph this bar chart, and then it comes out with a statistical average. And then my global KD is 1.51. I mean, really? That's not hard. I hope you guys don't think this is hard to implement. I mean, the graphics and anything behind this, Visual Basics, whatever they're using to make these graphics, I mean, I'm just saying, for real. The last five TDM matches, a 3.77 KD, 288 KD, 365, 395, and a 450. I mean, excuse me, that's my score per minute. But let's look at my best rig, Synaptic. Okay, so the best rigs to me will always be the first two rigs that's available in the game, because if you're a prestiger like myself, then you're continuously prestige, so you're not looking to switch amongst all the other characters. You're going to mainly be working on the first two guns, the first two characters, or anything that you've unlocked with your prestige tokens. Simple, right? Not impressed. Warfighter. Are you impressed? I'm not impressed. I might be impressed with myself because I actually have taken the time out to use every rig class and be proficient in those classes. If you're just looking at my kill death ratio in every class, I've actually performed well in every class. So I'm not doing bad. You're looking at the kills and the number of rewinds to rewind kills. I mean, that's really off. So that just shows that rewind, if I wanted to take these statistics and actually really take an in-depth look at them, I would say the rewind uses versus the rewind kills tells me that rewind is more used for defense more so than offense. It's to get me out of harm's way. So that's why I use it so many times and rather not get a whole bunch of kills. But let's look at something that does have an offensive and defensive element, and that's the claw. I use the claw 314 times, and I have 442 claw kills. That means I have an average of probably about 4 to 5 kills per time that I use the claw. Do the math, right? So let's look at the Merc, the reactive armor. It's used for defense as well as offense. So the reactive armor is something that I would should be continuously using, and if I want to have a higher KD within a game, then this is the rig that I would keep using. 257 uses and 2.12 kills. Let's check out the Striker. The Striker also yields great the Centurion uses. It yields a great kill death ratio if you use that. 55 uses, 37 kills. The Micro Turret, 42 uses, 35 kills. And that gravity weapon, I mean, it's kind of average. I don't know. And look here. Active camo. Active camo will get you some kills, but not that pulse. That pulse doesn't work well for me. It's not fitting for my playing style. And then you can look here. So this data will tell me this is good data, because this data will help me understand which rigs suit my play style and which rigs I should really be using versus the other rigs. This is probably the only shining light that I could say that I could see that's helping me out in this game. But everything else, these cluster grenades, peripherals, I use them for fodder. I just use them to just throw out there, and if I get somebody, I get somebody. But as you could tell, I'm no good at them. I don't really use them. I can care less about them. I really, if I'll show you my classes, it doesn't matter These things is fodder for me. Tacticals, pretty much the same thing. I just throw those things out. I don't expect a kill. It's just fodder to me. This data just tells me, Wayne, don't even use these things. But when I go to my best streaks, of course the Warden is. Why wouldn't I use the Warden? Warden gets you a lot of kills, right? So this is good data. So I kept calling this video the bad and the ugly, right? It's still bad and it's still ugly because these are the only things, these are the only shining two lights of everything that I've seen. Looking at the rigs I use and looking at the streaks I use, which ones yield the most damage and which ones I'm more proficient with. So these are the only things that I would say was a shining light in the leaderboards and the combat records. These are the things that I use. And this thing, the RCA, that thing is a monster, dude. You get that thing equipped, which is the highest score streak. I don't understand why it should be that high. I think they should pull it down a little bit. The Thor, I don't really like the Thor. I'll use it, but I don't really like it. This is garbage. The Apex is pretty nice. Trinity Rockets, really. You can get some kills with Trinity Rockets. Scarab is a waste of time. Scorches really is a waste of time. The Vulture is the new thing. Everybody's using the Vulture. I'm going to tell you right now, if you're not using the Vulture as one of your score streaks, you really need to think about it. Using the Warden is always going to grant you some kills because it takes maybe 4 shots just to get it down, right? And that Vulture, if you hook it up with the Striker package where he gets his Harden and he can make everything that he uses actually harder to all his lethal stuff, it's harder to knock down. You know, you hook it up with that and you'll see that you get a lot of kills. And the support, you know, I'm a support player, so I'm going to make sure I throw those UAVs up just for those folks who ain't running ghosts. If you ain't running ghosts, what are you doing? If you ain't running ghosts, dead silence, and forget dexterity and all that other stuff, you know, you could do other things to make yourself reload. But if you're not actually using ghost, blind eye, and what's that, a dead silence, you sleeping straight up, you sleeping. These are the ones that I use the most. You sleeping. And what's this? Okay, so this is going to tell you what games I play the most and how proficient I am at those games. Defender's trash. It's just a spawn trap. Defender, spawn trap to me, waiting to happen. So why would I even play that game? Free for all, that's what you just get your warm up on, you just get your practice on. I'm okay at it. I mean, I don't play it a lot. Hardcore, kill confirm. I do play hardcore. The reason why I play hardcore is not because I have a bad connection. The reason why I play hardcore is to make me more proficient at the game. Let me not depend on the minimap as much as to where I should be knowing where everything is, where everything is happening. Look at the flow of the game, understanding where the spawn points are. That's why you would want to work in some of those areas to do that. Drop zone, I mean, come on, really? Team deathmatch, that's where I spend most of my time. Most of my time is spent in team deathmatch. A lot of people will say, well, garbage players, they stay in team deathmatch. That's an absolute fallacy. And if you believe it, you got another thing coming because TDM is so random. But then again, it's not random. TDM is not random because they have specific spawn points depending on where the bulk of your team is. So anybody who ever says that team deathmatch is for noobs, that's where all the noobs are. All the noobs are playing domination. Why? Because you know if you take certain amount of flags, you know specifically that the other team is going to be in a specific area at that time and they're going to spawn at a certain point all the time. Domination, you will always know where the spawn points are. So don't tell me domination, if anything, is the easiest game because it's not random. It is very specific. I know I'm on my high horse. Again, ginger tea. It's good for your digestive system. When you get a little bit older, you know about that. Anyway, here's the rest of the stats. Here's the rest of my stuff from the combat record. Again, I'm an average gamer. I'm not the best dude on the block, but I'm okay. All right. I think I'm okay enough to be on YouTube and I can actually give you guys some pointers. I think I'm good enough to do that. So I've shown everything in there. Sometimes I don't want to show the leaderboards because on the leaderboards, I actually, you know, I got some other peeps that they're actually on there and I don't want to show their stuff, right? So let's just look at my classes real quick before I end this stream. This is my class right here, with the MV4 Chaos. That's what I'm using. That the Chaos is. That's nice. Look at that camo. Whew, that is nice. That American camo. I'm telling you, I got other camos than that, but this American camo is nice. Anyway, use that Elo sight because you know that Elo sight is on point. Quick draw, silencer. I want to be off the map. I want to always be off the map. Remember, I told you, rock that dead silence. Dead silence. Please use it. It counters tracker. I use scavenger with this because I run out of ammo really quickly. I'm shooting a lot. And then, of course, you know, I got that ghost and that blind eye. I'm telling you guys, run blind eye. If you want to do anything, run blind eye, run ghost, and run dead silence. It is the savior. All my classes almost look very similar. Just that camo I was telling you guys about to change colors all the time. You can see it right now. You see it changing colors like every 3 seconds. That's that hotness. The E-Rat is the business. I'm telling you right now, the E-Rat will lay you down. And of course, what I have with that is that particle amp giving me that long range of motion of shots. And then, of course, that foregrip, because you are able to shoot longer distance with this weapon and the high rapid fire. And it's an SMG. You don't need quick draw. All you need is foregrip. Same things except here. I use the attack resistance. If I'm running around a lot, then that means I'm rushing. This is my rushing class. And what's going to happen is I'm going to run into all these different things. So that's why I put the attack resistance. So I can just run around the map and act silly. My blind eye class, you know, I'm definitely using that blind eye class because I'm going to be shooting down stuff. I need to be off the map. Of course, again, I got a silencer. You know, this time I'm using hardwired because I'm specifically, this class is for me to support my team in all aerial things that are up in the air, whether it's a Thor, whether it's a counter UAV, whether it's a UAV, whether it's an advanced UAV. You got to shoot that stuff down to get the win for your team. Look at that raw. Whew. Put that silencer on it too. Look at that camo. Check out that. Let me show you what that camo looks like. That's this one. Check it out. Are you there? That's the camo. Again, silencer. Keep off the map. Keep your kills up. Blind eye. Gotta have it. Because people got all those things as around the map. So you want to stay off. You want blind eye. Got that MacTav. It's my ice cube icebreaker. That igloo buster. I don't use it as much as I used to. But when you run it, throw the hollow point on there. Get them headshots off. Get them people killed real quick. And then you know that 3-round burst that everybody, a lot of people are using that R3K. They're using it. It's a headbanger. Definitely a headbanger. Again, same stuff. Ghost, blind eye. Gotta have dead silence. I don't need to be hearing nobody else's footsteps. Then here's my loadout. See the score streaks right there? Easy to achieve. Not very hard. Once you get your UAV, you get a couple of points from your UAV. Then that vulture's ready. Once you got that vulture, you're going to get your warden. I could change the setup. I've gone for the highest score streaks. I've gone for the lowest. These are just the ones that I believe just help me get through the game and keep a decent kill death ratio. Should I open this up? See what I get? Just throw something in here a little bit extra. I know I'm making the stream longer than it should be. I'm supposed to be complaining.
Good news. That's some quality gear.
I'm supposed to be complaining, and I did my complaining in the beginning of this video. So I'm not the type of dude that's going to keep complaining throughout the whole video. You know what I'm saying? It's my emblem setup right there. Just something simple. Nothing too crazy. You know what I mean? I ain't got to do all that. So, again, guys, the implementation of the leaderboards and the combat records, it has taken way too long. It shouldn't have gone there. Then they want to extend the mission team. So now the mission teams go up to 100. Rather than the 50 that it was before. So now you got to just keep on pushing on. They act like this thing is destiny. I ain't trying to grind all that stuff out. I'm going to just play it just to be playing it. And if I get it, I get it. You know what I'm saying? I'm Prestige 4. I'm trying to hit that Prestige 5. You guys have seen my medals before. You already know what it is. The ones that I like the most. Where are they? Combat. Combat's the one that means something to me. Triple kills, furies, frenzies, super kills, Mega kills, ultra kills. Those are the ones that mean something to me. I still got to get that chain kill. I don't have that yet. Got to at least get one of those. Again, there's a combat record. That's my KD. It is what it is. My win loss is really low. I'm a solo player. I haven't been playing with my friends because this Call of Duty kind of is dead. You know what I mean? A lot of my friends don't have it. A lot of people think it's trash. It's not a really bad game. It's an okay game, but the implementation of everything that it did to this game is suspect. You took too long for all this stuff. You took way too long to get all this data available to the player so they can understand and analyze their own analytics to see if they're getting better or they can get better and in which areas they can improve. This is the data that's supposed to help the player achieve that or compare themselves to their other friends. This is the data that does that. This is the stuff. But you took too long to implement it. I think 3 months is too long. Way too damn long. I don't get it. It just pisses me off. Again, these are the things that the proficiency is there. You should only use the ones that you are truly proficient at. Those are the ones you should keep on. All the other stuff that's trash, you don't do well with it, take it off. It's a waste of your time. See that? These are the things I'm most proficient with. You know what I mean? It's just, it's crazy. I'll jump to a leaderboard real quick. Let me see. Score. I'll just do score. You know what I mean? You might recognize some of these names. Mighty in Christ. Dr. Evil. There's some other YouTubers out there. All the rest of these people. The Great Dansby. Ryan Kona, he doesn't stream anymore or put anything up. But these, and they only give you, what's the deal with this? If you're on your friends, and I got more friends than this to play the game, we got 15 people. Like, why can only see 15 people? Wins, got the good dudes. You know what I'm saying? I mean, what's up with that? This is crazy. This stuff is crazy. Anyway. This has been your boy Wayne, the Average Gamer, just on a little rant. Just wanted to share with you guys the bad and the ugly implementing of the leaderboards and actually also the combat record. It took Infinity Ward too long. If I was Activision, I wouldn't pay them. If I was Activision, I would never allow them to make another Call of Duty game ever in life, and I would ban them as a FPS shooter distributor. That's just me, you know, and I'm out. Deuces. Peace.